Our program begins with one of the most radical challenges to traditional college campuses to date, the ability to earn a degree without ever being in a classroom or having a professor. The experiment is happening in New Hampshire.
Once again, just giving you kind of a broad overview.
For more than a century, higher education has relied on the credit hour. Students earn credit for hours spent in class. In turn, credits add up to a college degree.
Under a traditional historical common law definition.
And while the credit hour is still the mainstay here at Southern New Hampshire University, a private institution of 17,000 students, the school has also embarked on a movement that questions the very value of the college classroom. President Paul LeBlanc says the nation invests too much in the idea of the credit hour.
We give $153 billion of federal financial aid out every year based on the credit hour. But the credit hour is really good at one thing, or at least the principal thing, which is telling people how long you sat. How long were you in class? It's not very good at telling people what you've actually learned.
Under LeBlanc's leadership, Southern New Hampshire University has launched College for America, an online degree program with no classes, no professors, and no credit hours.
Rather than measuring how long someone sat, the old credit hour construct, we actually have a program that measures what you learn. And we throw time sort of out the window.
So how is this different than online universities that have existed for years now?
Almost all of online education today is still based on the credit hour in the course. We don't have any courses and we don't have any credit hours, but we have 120 competencies. And you can master those as fast as you like or as slow. The thing that we don't care very much about is time. And that is such a fundamental reversal of the basic structure of higher education.
Last year, President Obama cited the new program as an innovative way to make college more affordable.
Southern New Hampshire University gives course credit based on how well students master the material, not just on how many hours they spend in the classroom. So the idea would be, if you're learning the material faster, you can finish faster, which means you pay less and you save money.
The College for America has found a way to deliver more skills.
An associate's degree at College for America costs $5,000, a bachelor's, $10,000. In its first year, the school had 600 students spread out across 39 states.
We have finally truly innovated a College for America.
When do you stop that?
Students like Sue Shipka, a widower from Burlington, Massachusetts, who had tried to earn a degree once before while raising her three children.
I'm sitting in class and I'm thinking of my kids are home with a babysitter, I'm not there, and everything else that I have to do, and you know, I could be working overtime to pay the bills, or you know, there's so many other things. So my mind was preoccupied, I wasn't in class, you know, so it wasn't really helpful. I'll have you sit in the chair and we'll go over one chair and I'll put a bandage on.
A licensed practical nurse, Shipka hopes an associate's degree will lead to a job in hospital management with a higher salary and fewer hours.
It'll free up some time so I can spend more time with the kids, even though they're getting older. You know, working full time, I missed a lot of time.
This model says, look, if you've been working for 20 years and you look at the math competencies and you say, I got these cold, why would we make you sit through 16 weeks of course or class time? Go ahead, demonstrate that you actually, in fact, have mastered these and then move on.
Have you sit up in the chair?
But if College for America has no courses and no professors, how do its students qualify for a degree? That's where Chief Academic Officer Kathro Kazin comes in.
I think that fits very nicely with our competencies on quality management.
Kazin oversees a team of subject matter experts, academics, and industry leaders who are responsible for degree content.
What we did was to take a model degree and then kind of break it apart. So we identified the key competencies that a student should develop in the course of earning that degree.
Students are given a series of projects to complete on their own time. The projects are evaluated by experts, an approach called direct assessment.
The projects are organized around certain themes. Each project is associated with a certain number of competencies. So for instance, you might have competencies that involve critical thinking, communication skills, quantitative reasoning. You would demonstrate those by doing a business memo, for instance, with a spreadsheet that attacked a particular business problem. You might curate a virtual museum exhibit so that you would be showing people how you look at art, right? So they're all very, very carefully crafted.
We were talking about the insurgency.
But awarding competency-based credits has generated some skepticism among faculty at other institutions.
the purpose of a college education is actually to produce insight, not competency. Okay.
So Associate Professor Johan Neem from Western Washington University says college classrooms foster much more than competency.
The reality is, seat time is a bad way of thinking about what happens in a classroom. It's actually about actively engaging with material. It's thinking time. That's when brains are engaged. That's when minds are thinking. That's when people are talking to people. And that's what this is all about, ultimately.
For now, College for America targets adults like Sue Shipka.
Our program is designed for those 40 million working adults who might have some credits but no degree. And this is true at a time when 70% of all new jobs will require a two-year degree or its equivalent. We've got a huge crisis in this country of preparing our workforce, and what College for America is really designed to do is serve those working adults.
The college has partnered with more than 50 companies that sponsor employees who are interested in pursuing a degree. Sue Shipka's employer, Partners Healthcare of Massachusetts, is paying half of her $5,000 tuition.
Hey.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
But LeBlanc sees a much bigger role for competency-based education. He currently leads a group of 20 colleges and universities that discuss competency-based best practices. The group was recently funded by the Lumina Foundation, which also funds the NewsHour.
I mean, this is a fairly disruptive idea. Does higher education need this disruption now?
I think competency-based education looms large as a disruptive force in higher education, because what it allows you to do is when you reverse that time is fixed, learning is variable kernel, and you start to unbundle all of what goes into learning, you can start to think about very new business models, different ways to bring learning to people. And that's very powerful.
Using everything we know.
The Department of Education has weighed in and approved the use of federal aid for students attending College for America. The department is currently evaluating applications from several more institutions.